last seen in Woodsville, drew media and law enforcement comparisons due to the similarities in the cases. Nevertheless, state police have asserted that there are no connections between the two incidents. In both April and June, law enforcement agencies in New Hampshire and Vermont refuted any links between the cases of Murray and Maitland. In an official statement, they expressed their belief that Maura was en route to an undisclosed location and may have accepted a ride to reach that destination, further noting that they had found no evidence indicating that a crime had occurred. They also ruled out the involvement of a serial killer. In 2005, Fred Murray sought assistance from New Hampshire Governor Craig Benson regarding the search for his missing son. Additionally, he appeared on the Montel Williams Show in November 2004 to raise awareness about the case. On February 9, 2005, marking the first anniversary of his son's disappearance, a memorial service was conducted at the location where the vehicle was discovered, during which Fred had a brief meeting with New Hampshire Governor John Lynch. Later in 2005, Fred initiated legal action against multiple law enforcement agencies in an effort to obtain case files. On November 1, 2005, an individual using the name Tom Davies posted on a message board named Not Without Peril, which focused on discussions surrounding Murray's disappearance. He claimed to have spotted a black backpack resembling Murray's behind a restroom at Pemigewasset Overlook, approximately 30 miles east of Woodsville along Route 112. Senior Assistant Attorney General Jeffrey Strelzin confirmed that law enforcement was aware of the backpack, but did not reveal whether it had undergone forensic analysis. In 2014, marking the 10th anniversary of Maura Murray's disappearance, Strelzin remarked, "We have not received any credible sightings of Maura since the evening she went missing." An article in the New York Daily News on this significant anniversary reported that Fred Murray held the belief that his daughter was deceased and had been abducted on the night she vanished. On February 9, 2017, the 13th anniversary of her disappearance, Strelzin communicated via email to the Boston Globe stating, "This case remains open, experiencing periods of activity interspersed with times of dormancy. Currently, there are no new developments to report." In February 2019, during the 15th anniversary of Maura's disappearance, Fred reiterated his conviction that his daughter was no longer alive, expressing his concerns regarding a nearby residence that cadaver dogs had indicated, asserting, "I truly believe that is my daughter." In early April, an excavation was conducted in the basement of that house. Fred had previously sought to investigate the property, but the original owners were uncooperative. After the property changed hands, the new owners permitted several searches. However, the excavation in early April yielded no significant findings, aside from what seemed to be a fragment of pottery or old piping. In early 2021, the tree at the location where Murray was last seen, which had been adorned with a blue ribbon as a tribute, was removed by the property owner. Shortly after this event, a request from Murray's family for the installation of a historical marker in New Hampshire at the site, submitted in late 2020, was denied by the New Hampshire Division of Historical Resources. The case of Murray's disappearance has been referred to as the first crime mystery of the social media era, sparking considerable speculation among both the media and the public, particularly on the internet through various online forums and message boards. In a 2014 article for Boston Magazine, Bill Jensen remarked, "At least in the online realm, it often appears that cold cases do not exist." However, when Maura Murray vanished, the social web was still in its early stages. YouTube and Twitter were not yet available. On the day of her disappearance, Facebook had only been active for 5 days. Thus, one can interpret the narrative of her case as a reflection of the development of online investigation. In 2005, discussions surrounding Murray's disappearance were actively recorded on websleuths.com, and by 2007, dedicated Facebook and MySpace pages were established to assist in the search for her. Following the years subsequent to Murray's disappearance, her case attracted considerable media coverage from various outlets, including ABC News, News Nation, and StoryCorps. It was featured on television programs such as American Morning, The Montel Williams Show, 2020, Nancy Grace's Cold Cases, Disappeared, and The Dr. Oz Show. Print media attention came from the Boston Globe, People Magazine, Newsweek, 17 Magazine, The New Yorker, and Rolling Stone, along with numerous local and regional newspapers, magazines, and radio and television broadcasts. Additionally, the case sparked extensive discussion on internet message boards.